Hello folks, it's with your motorcycles, and today we're going to be doing a quick product spotlight and a very, very brief installation instructions on a, what do we call this thing? It's the heavy duty spare wheel luggage rack. So we're going to be replacing this old spare wheel luggage rack with the new style that was introduced on the Geo Limited Edition. Now they're in stock and they're available for you to replace your rack or add one to your bike if it wasn't previously equipped. But before we get started, my boss Ilya wanted me to remind everybody to subscribe to our channel, click the notification button. That way you can be the first in the know to get updates from us regarding what's going on with the company and also new products for your bike. So without further delay, we're going to turn this to this. So the first order of business is to remove the spare wheel nut. I couldn't find my wrench, so I'm using Sergei's. And if he watches this video, he will be upset that I borrowed it without asking. Set that aside, you'll be reusing it. Now you're going to lower the rack out of the way and remove the spare tire. To remove the old rack, you're just going to pry these apart a little bit and slip one side out. Now the new rack comes with the stand-ups required that bolt to the existing hardware on the trunk strap or the trunk hinge. And what that does is it receives into the rack, and with the combination of the spare wheel nut and these two points, it prevents it from rotating, and then the rack has little stand-ups that press against the tire, and this will work on an 18 or a 19 inch wheel and tire assembly. So it'll work on a gear up or some of the CTs that came equipped with 18 inch. The slant part goes towards the front and the open part goes to the outside. So they're literally gonna sit just like that. Disassembly and assembly literally requires a 13 millimeter wrench or socket and a 5 millimeter Allen tool or hex tool, whatever you want to call it, 5 millimeter, 13 millimeter. So we're going to open the trunk and we're going to remove these brackets here. Once the bracket's removed, take the hardware, put it back, replace the flat washer and the lock nut. Washer, lock nut, and then tighten those back down. The trunk hinges actually use two different lengths of hardware. 16 millimeter, where it's only going through the trunk hinge itself, and 20 millimeter, where it's going through the trunk hinge and another item. So these are 20, these are 16, it's 20, six. These were 20 because it had the hinges on it. 16, 16, 16, 16, and so forth. So the when you put these back in where the hinges were, they're going to be a little longer. So if you want to get 16 millimeter hardware to put in there, you can do that. And then these ones, when you remove them and you add the extra thickness of this standoff as well, there's still enough threads for the lock nut to engage. Now we're going to remove these two upper bolts. You don't have to worry about this falling because you got the two lower bolts that are going to hold it in place for you. Now when you remove this hardware, like I said, see the angle that goes towards the front, and the open side goes towards the outside of the sidecar. So that goes back in there. Flat washer, and then get the lock nut started. You can do the same thing with the other side. And then you're going to tighten these down. And that's all there is to it. You ready to put the spare tire back on? And you'll notice how the standoffs sit in between the spokes. So depending on how it's orientated, it won't go. You need to make sure it's in the larger gap in the spokes. Now the first time you go to put this on, these little rubber bushings that are in the steel inserts for the standoffs, they're a little tight going onto these pins, so you might want to blast a little WD-40 in there. And maybe put a little on the pins themselves. Just to help it the first time it goes on. Over the pins. Press down. You can see the stem is in there. And your wheel nut goes back on. Right between these two runners. Take your spare wheel wrench. Tighten up your nut. You just want to get it until there's a little bit of tension on it. It doesn't have to be Hulk tight. And then these little standoffs on the four corners press against the sidewall of the tire. So you got pressure pushing up from the tire, pressure pushing down from the nut on the rack, and then the two pins keeping it from rotating. It's very, very stable. You want to make sure the point with the upsweep and it goes towards the back. That's to keep luggage or cargo or whatever you got on there from sliding off while you're strapping it down. Now our new rear rack has a load capacity of 20 kilograms, which is about 44 pounds. And it does match the front nose rack, which has a load capacity of 15 kilograms, which is about 33 pounds. So 20 kilograms, 44 pounds, 15 kilograms, about 33 pounds. Well, there you go, a shorter video, quick install, new product, available in the shop, heavy duty spare wheel luggage rack, part number IMZ-8.1041-16051. You can go to the shop by going to IMZ-URAL.com, click the shop tab, and it takes you right to our shop. You can look through the different categories for accessories, maintenance, and things like that. We've got new stuff going all the time, going up on the website all the time. And as Ilya advised me to say, please not only like my videos, but subscribe to our channel. That way you'll get notification when videos go up, and you'll be the first in the know when new information comes out about the happenings with the company new products or one of my videos relating to service. As always, I appreciate you watching, and I'll talk to you next time.